But first, we have breaking news inside a courtroom in Queens. The jury working late into this night and coming back with a verdict.
Guilty.
Cheers erupting from the family and friends of Karina Vetrano. Guilty on all counts for the man on trial for murdering the young jogger. And good evening, everyone. At 11 o'clock, I'm Bill Ritter.
And I'm Sade Berenois. The verdict's announced just about 90 minutes ago. Eyewitness News reporter Lucy Yang live at the courthouse with reaction from Vetrano's family. Lucy?
Well, Sade and Bill, it was a night of high drama and tensions released as those guilty verdicts came pouring in for the Vetrano family, who waited 3 agonizing years to hear those words. They basically erupted into a standing ovation.
We, the jury, find the defendant guilty.
The courtroom broke out in tears and screams and applause when the jury came back with guilty verdicts on all 4 counts. The 4 men reading loud and clear that they believe 22-year-old Channel Lewis murdered and sexually abused 30-year-old Karina Vetrano, whose only crime was going for a jog. Her parents leaving court tonight feeling like their prayers have finally been answered.
Say it again. Thank you, Jesus.
Sir, your thoughts?
Jubilation. Justice.
It was a hot August day in Howard Beach. Karina Vetrano went out for a run, but never came home. They eventually found her battered body deep in the park. It took 3 years and 2 trials to reach this moment of justice. The first trial ended in a hung jury in November when 5 jurors refused to believe that all the DNA evidence collected and 2 taped confessions were enough. This time, prosecutors packed their case with forensic evidence and emotions, as both parents testified about having their beloved daughter return to them in a casket.
This is what she looked like an hour before the defendant got his hands on her. And this is what she looked like after.
It brought at least 1 juror to tears. 5 hours later, guilty on all counts.
We, the jury, find the defendant guilty.
The defense attorney tried to argue that Lewis's DNA found in the victim's fingernails, neck, and cell phone did not make sense.
Police arrest the right person responsible.
He choked her and choked her and choked her.
Now, going forward, sentencing is scheduled for April 17th. Channel Lewis could face life in prison without parole. His attorney tonight calling this a miscarriage of justice and vowing to appeal.